Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Anna and today is my update for my Panda palette, which is my Norvina palette by Anastasia Beverly Hills. As you can see here, it's the purple one and I am excited for this update because I have some good news for you. Something very exciting has happened. So I would say let's hop right into it. So this is what my palette is looking like at the moment, and as you can see, I have finished two complete pans. It's the shade Dreamer and the shade Wild Child. They are completely empty now and I am beyond excited. I was really, I don't know, craving some more progress, so I'm happy to see these two gone and I hope that there are some that can follow in the next month. So this is what my palette is looking like at the moment. I have some huge dips in the mattes and also in the shimmers. I could expand a lot of the pans and I'm very, very excited at where we are at with this palette at the moment. Now let's just go through it shade by shade. So as you can see, Dreamer has been the champagne shade, the shimmer one, and I was able to finish it up completely. Everything is gone. I scraped everything out of the corners and now it's officially done and I'm so excited. It was very easy to finish it up because there was only the tiniest amount left in it. So I only used it maybe 2 to 3 times and then it was gone. Then the next shade is Summer. It's this beautiful golden metallic. I didn't reach for it a ton, but a few times, so I could expand the pan a bit. So I feel like that's kind of the course with the shimmers here in the top row, because I just continue to use them regularly, but not exclusively, and that way I can just have steady progress and I don't get bored with them. So I feel like I have been a bit more excited about the palette in the last month. So I will just continue using the metallics as I did on my lower lash line, sometimes on my crease, sometimes on my lid. It depends on what my mood and what my look is going to be. So yeah, rose gold is another one that I love so much. The other day I did a smoky eye with this one all over my lid, and this is crazy good for a smoky eye because it has this very, very deep black base and it looks so sultry all over the lid, because when you look straight up onto the eye, it looks like this rose gold, so very bright and metallic and foiled. And then when you shift your head, it looks like you have a black on the lid, and that is so, I don't know, I feel like it's so interesting and so cool. So I really do like this one for that. So I feel like I wanna use it more in this way, because usually I did use it more in the outer corner to deepen things up because it has this black base to it, but as a smoky eye, it adds something totally different to a look. So it's pretty, pretty cool. Then Celestial, as you can see, I was able to use up this left corner here. So now we have only 3 corners left and my goal until the next update is to use up the right top corner so that I only have the bottom half left here. I'm also just continuing to use it as I did before in my crease, on the lower lash line. I love it on my lower lash line because it has a bit of depth to it, although it appears a bit sheer. So when you apply it on the lid, it looks a bit sheer, but when you apply it wet to the lower lash line, it looks a bit darker and it adds a beautiful purple shift. So I wanna continue to use this on my lower lash line. It looks so beautiful. And also on my outer corner, in my crease, I do really enjoy this shade. I just don't like it on my lid because I feel like it's a bit lackluster on the lid and also a bit too dark for me. So I prefer this one in other ways. Oh, and I forgot, I totally skipped Wild Child. Because, you know, it's empty, so why talk about it? But no, so I want to update you. I was able to use up Wild Child completely. It was a pleasure to use because it's such an easy shade. I just threw it all over the lid and I was done. So I did one of my favorite looks that I did a lot in the beginning of this project, where I just put Love in the crease, then Passion to deepen up the outer corner, and then Wild Child on the lid. So it's a very easy rosy pinky look, and I did that a few times and then it was totally gone. I'm so excited to have another empty in this palette, my first two empties, and I'm so excited. I really did need this little boost of motivation, so I'm now really, really back into this project and I'm very much motivated now. Then the next shade is Dazzling, this beautiful coppery rose gold, and I still love it on my lower lash line. It's my favorite way of using this one here, and I have another way of using it because of my Pandos eyeshadows project. I did discover a look that I fell in love with, and it's kind of a two-toned metallic look where I combine a warm toned metallic and a cool toned metallic. So I mean metallic in metal, so I combine kind of like a bronze or copper shade and then a silver, so I feel like they clash, and it's very, I don't know, I feel like it's very on trend at the moment to have this mixed metals look, and it looks so beautiful. I don't know why, but I completely fell in love with that because I've had a kind of a copper and a silver in my Pandas eyeshadows project. I did do the look automatically one day and then I fell head over heels for it. So now I feel like I want to continue doing this look but with Dazzling, because that's a great way to use up this eyeshadow. So I hope that I can maybe hit side pen in this one until the next update. We will see. I don't want to put any pressure on me with this one, but I feel like it's doable, so it would be great to hit side pen in this one. Then Drama, I could expand the pen quite a lot and I'm so surprised. I really thought that Drama would be the hardest one to use up, and now I feel like it's one of the easiest ones because I can use it as an eyeliner. I do love it as a deepening shade for my outer corner. I just put it on a pencil brush and then I wet the brush and then I apply it to my outer corner. Then it adds kind of like a goopy blackish paste. And then I just diffuse it with a more fluffy brush and with my transition shade, and it blends out to the most beautiful, very dark black and gray color. And it looks so beautiful. And when it's a bit more dry, then it also adds the purple sheen back to it. So it's stunning for the outer corner. I love it as that. It just has a lot of fallout, as mentioned before. It's not my favorite for that, but other than that, I love this eyeshadow. So I feel like I will have more progress until the next update, and I also want to try and hit side pen in it, maybe in the top, maybe on the left hand side here, so we will see, but I would love to hit side pen in this one. Then let's talk about base, because I'm almost done with it. I only have the tiniest amount left here in the right bottom corner, so this will definitely be done until the next update. I can't wait to have another one used up, and this will be it. I'm sure of it because I have the tiniest amount left in it. It's a beautiful matte cream eyeshadow. I use it all the time. So this will be gone until the next update. Then Soul, I have only used a few times. I don't know why. I just don't reach for it at the moment, but I feel like its time will come and I still love this eyeshadow. So I feel like I can easily use it up, but maybe I'm just a bit too optimistic. I don't know, because I mean I don't reach for blues every day, but this one is different, so I feel like I just have to use it a bit more, but it's a beautiful shade. I love it. I just didn't use it a ton. So I hope that it looks similar to before, because my camera cut off, because the power was running low, so I've had to charge it a bit. And now I'm continuing, so we will continue with the next shade, which is called Incense. And this one here, as you can see, I was able to hit pan in it, and not only hit pan, but hit major pan, because I hope that you can see it. I have a huge dip in it and also a pretty huge pan in it, because I've discovered that this is one of my favorite shades in this palette. I don't know how this happens all the time, that I just discover new shades that I love in this palette. And also in my other, in my Pandas eyeshadows project pen, I have the same thing going on. I always discover new favorite shades and then I don't like the ones that I liked before, and it always changes. It's so interesting, and that's why I love these projects so much. So incense is one of the shades that I wasn't really looking at before, and then I started using it just to hit pan, and then I've discovered that it's the perfect transition shade for every day. I can use it with every single eyeshadow look that I do, because this is such a neutral color that I can barely see it, but it just adds the tiniest amount of shadow, and it's perfect as a transition shade and also as a crease shade. So this is great. It's great for my transition area, it's great for my crease. It's just a perfect base for every neutral look and also for colorful looks. It's just so easy. So that's why I have this huge pan, because I reach for it and I use it pretty much every day and every time I do my eyeshadow. So I feel like this will be easy to use up, and I now think that this might be the first matte that will be gone. So we will see. I want to expand the pan until the next update. I think this will be possible, and I love this eyeshadow now. Then the next one is Love. I could expand the pan a tiny bit. I didn't use it that much, but a few times, and it was nice. I just feel like, you know, pinks are not my favorites. This shade is quite beautiful. It is a beautiful tone of pink. I do like the eyeshadow when I look at it, when I see it. I do also kind of like it when I apply it. I just don't like a pink look on me in general. So it's just I don't like pinks on me, but this one is actually pretty beautiful. I just have to, you know, apply other things on top of it so that it's not only pink. So I love applying this one on top of it and also using this one as a transition shade and then doing a smoky eye with passion. It's beautiful. So I love combining these two together. It is a beautiful eyeshadow. I'm glad that I could use up a bit more. So I'm trying to, you know, continue steady to use it. I just want to use it a few times every month, and then I hope that it will be also done by the end of the year. Then the next shade is Volatile, one of my favorites again. It's a cool tone eyeshadow. I've used it quite some times, not too many because I was using incense that much. So I was kind of taking a step back from Volatile, but I still love it. And I feel like its time will come when I have to go to work more, because I have some free time at the moment. And so that's why I'm also able to film a bit more frequently and upload more frequently. So I'm glad that I have a bit more time for my YouTube channel now, but I know that when I have to work more, I will be continue to use this one a lot more again. So I really don't worry about this shade. I think this will be gone in no time, so this will be an easy one to finish up. Then I was also able to hit pan in Eccentric. I'm so excited. I really wasn't sure if I could do it, but I just used it a few more times in my crease and then all over my lid, and then I packed passion on top of it. So these two go very well together, and I have to say, when I, you know, tone it down a bit with some other cool tones like Volatile, I can make this eyeshadow work, but it's not my favorite. It's just a bit too warm, so I don't really want to reach for it, but I can make me reach for it. It's just I'm not really enjoying this one, but at least I have hit pan. But I'm not sure if I want to force myself to use it up completely, because I really don't like it that much. And I feel like if I can use up all the other shades in this palette, it would be okay for me to just have Eccentric left and then, you know, just be done with this palette and just didn't use up Eccentric. I think that would be okay for me. So maybe I'm going to do that. We will see in the future month. But for now, you know, I want to continue to slowly use it, but I don't want to force myself too much to use it. And then at last we have Passion. This is this beautiful burgundy shade. I love this shade so, so much. It's such a beautiful color, and I love it for deepening up looks and also for doing like a beautiful burgundy smoky eye. I've used it once and it's just a beautiful eyeshadow. I just wish it would be a bit darker so that I can also use it as an eyeliner, but it's just a tiny bit too light for that. But it's a beautiful eyeshadow, and I could expand the pan quite a bit, and I hope to continue to expand the pan. So this is it for my update today. Now I'm going to show you some looks that I've created. I have only two looks for you today because I couldn't really film a lot of what I was doing, and I was repeating the looks that I created a ton. So there is not so much to show you, but I have two. So in this first look that you can see, I've used Incense as a transition shade, and then I have used Volatile to deepen the crease up a bit. And then I have on my lid, the very sparkly one is Ripple, a single eyeshadow from Cléonard from the Stained Glass collection. And then on the outer corner I have Carving, and then also Drama. So I love using Drama as an outer corner deepening shade. It just adds a bit of a black and it's beautiful. And then I do have also some other single eyeshadows on my lower lash line. And this is just like a perfect example to show you that I use my palette mainly for the mattes, and then I add something sparkly on top of it on the lid. And you can basically see the same thing here in the second look, where I just used Volatile on my outer corner in my crease, and then I put a Glammatric single eyeshadow in the shade Paratwinkle on my lid. On my lower lash line, on the inner part, I do have a depotted eyeshadow from Juvia's Place. It was the light gold one from the Siren 2 palette. And then on the outer part of my lower lash line, I do have Celestial. As you can see, it's a beautiful, a bit deeper purple for me, so it's perfect for my lower lash line. And I just love simple and easy looks, and this is so fairy-like, and I love looks like this. So, as you can see again, I just basically used the mattes in this eyeshadow palette and then topped it off with some single eyeshadows. So I'm excited and I'm very happy for this update, and I hope that you are too. Let me know what you think. Will I be able to finish this whole palette until the end of the year? I don't know. I feel like the matte could take so much more time to use up, so I'm a bit anxious about them now, because I mean, base takes me so long to finish, and it's a cream color, so I can use it all over my lid, so I don't know. I don't know if I can finish all the mattes, but I mean, at least use up a ton of them would be enough for me, so yeah. I hope that you did enjoy this video. Thank you all so much for watching. I will see you in my next one, and I wish you all a beautiful day.